During a deposition, why would I ever say objection? That's irrelevant. But go ahead and answer the question. Why would I do that? Would you like to learn the answer? Come join me for a moment as I share with you some great information. Hi, I'm Gerry Oginski. I'm a New York medical malpractice and personal injury attorney. All right, you brought a lawsuit against your doctor claiming that he was careless and that his carelessness caused you significant harm and injury. Your doctor denies all of those claims. And now what happens? Now your case goes through the discovery phase. And during the course of discovery, there will be a time where you will be questioned by the attorney who represents the doctor whom you have sued. We call this a deposition. It's really a pretrial question and answer session that's given under oath. Lawyers also call this an examination before trial. So now, during the course of this question and answer session, which takes place, by the way, in our conference room, and you should know there's no judge present, there's no jury present, but there is a court reporter there to record all of the questions you are asked and all of the answers that you give. And you should know something in case you don't already. The answers that you give during this question and answer session represent your sworn testimony, and it carries the same exact weight as if you are testifying at trial in court in front of a jury. So now, during the course of you being questioned, there will come a time where I will say, "Objection, counselor, that's an improper question." And then I will turn to you and say, "Mr. Jones, go ahead and answer that question." Now, why would I do that? Why would I tell you it's okay to answer a question that's not proper or a question that is not relevant to the issues in this case? You want to know why? Because in New York, in these civil cases, you, as the person who is bringing the lawsuit, you are legally required to answer these questions because this is the discovery phase. This is an opportunity for the defense, the opposing attorney, to ask you questions about what happened, about your background, about your medical history, about your injuries, and about how your injuries have affected you on a daily basis. Now, there will be instances where the defense attorney will ask you a question that I think is totally inappropriate, or totally unrelated to the issues in this case, or unrelated to the defenses in this case, in which case I'm going to object. Now, why do I tell you to go ahead and still answer the question? Because there are only two real instances during a civil case in New York involving a medical malpractice case, an accident case, or even a wrongful death case, where I can legally and appropriately tell you, don't answer that question. And those two instances are, one, in a question that asks for what it is that you and your attorney talked about, because the opposing lawyer can't ask questions that are confidential, and anything you say to your attorney, anything your attorney says to you, is confidential and private, and we call it privileged. So in that instance, I'm fully within my right to say, don't answer that question. Another instance where it would be inappropriate for you to answer is if the lawyer asks you some crazy off-the-wall question having nothing whatsoever to do with the facts of this case or the defenses of the case. Something like, "Hey, Mr. Jones, how many times do you beat your wife each night?" What? What are you talking about? That's a ridiculous question. In that instance, that would be totally inappropriate. And then I could tell you, don't answer that question. But every other question that the attorney asks you has to be answered, even though I don't agree with it, even if I think it's irrelevant, even if we believe it's nothing to do with the case. He has a right to ask that question and get an answer. And even though you don't want to answer it, even though I think you should not answer it, the problem is we are legally obligated to tell you that you need to answer that question. So that's why you will hear me make the objection on the record. Objection! That's an improper question. Objection! That's irrelevant. But go ahead and answer the question anyway. So why do I share this quick information with you? Because this happens in every single case. Every single case where there's a deposition, at some point during the questioning, an attorney asks a question that I think is inappropriate, I go ahead and make my objection, and now I have to tell my client whether or not he can go ahead and answer the question. And in almost every instance, the answer is yes, he has to. You know, I realize you're watching this video because you have questions or concerns about your own matter. Well, if your matter did happen here in New York, and you're thinking about bringing a lawsuit, but haven't done so yet because you still have questions that need to be answered, what I invite you to do is pick up the phone and call me. You know, I answer questions like yours every single day, and I'd love to talk to you. You can reach me at 516-487-8207 or by email at Gerry, G-E-R-R-Y, at oginski-law.com. That's it for today's video. I'm Gerry Oginski. Have a fantastic day.